वेलकम बैक। इन द प्रीवियस क्लास आई हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द बैलेंस्ड वाई वाई कनेक्शन एंड मीनिंग ऑफ वाई वाई कनेक्शन इज आवर बैलेंस्ड सोर्स इज कनेक्टेड इन वाई टोपोलॉजी एज वेल एज our load is also connected to the Y topology. In today's lecture, I am going to talk about the balanced Y delta connection. And this is perhaps the most practical three-phase system as the three-phase sources are usually Y connected, while the three phase loads are usually delta connected. So first let us see the definition of balanced Y delta connection. So a balanced Y delta system, because whenever we are adding source and load and after that wire, then we have some kind of input and output. So I can also define as a system. So Y delta system consists of a balanced Y connected source feeding a balanced delta connected load. This is the formal definition of the balanced Y delta connection. And in the previous class we have already understood that what is meaning of balance. Now I am not going to repeat it again and again. So let us see the topological connection. So here this is our basically source, and this part is our load. And here you can see that I have load voltage VAN with respect to neutral line, and N here represents the neutral line. But in this particular topology, means Y delta topology, because there is no way to connect here neutral line, so due to that reason I am assuming that neutral line is not connected from source to load. We are assuming that this neutral line is grounded or something, and after that we are assuming the voltage VAN with respect to neutral line. So this is phase voltage. Similarly, I have another phase voltage VBN, and third phase voltage is VCN, and I am assuming that positive sequence. So in the previous class we have seen that if rotor is rotated in counterclockwise direction, then we have ABC pattern, and that is called positive sequence. So let us now derive some kind of mathematical quantity, and again I have to establish relation between the voltage and current. So let us first write the assumption, and whenever you are doing something, assumption is one of the key point, because if we change assumption, then all analysis is going to change. So assumption is that this three phase source are connected in positive sequence . So basically we have ABC sequence. So if we assume this, then it is possible to write the phase voltage. So the phase voltage, again same as the previous class, are one can represent like this, means VAN is VP 0 degree, where VP is the RMS value. And similarly, I have VBN. So VBN is VP and phase angle with respect to A is 120. And VCN, that is VP and phase angle is plus 120 degree. So this kind of things we have already learned during the previous class, that if I have Y connected source, then in this way one can calculate the phase voltage. And from the phase voltage, we have also shown that using phasor diagram, that how to calculate the line voltage. So basically I can calculate the line voltages as VAB. After applying the phasor, we have seen that. So this is also, this result is also from the previous class. So it is better that you can first understood the previous class, then please come to this class. So that is VBA. After that, I have VBC. So that is root 3 VP, and that is 90 degree. And similarly, I have VCA, that is root 3 VP, and that is 150 degree. So in this way, I have calculated the line voltage. And let us try to see from the diagram that voltage, whatever line voltage between A and B, so I am talking about basically this particular voltage between these 2 points, and same voltage, it is possible, one can easily show that here whatever VAB, that is exactly equal to VAB. And similar kind of conclusion I can draw for if I will consider the voltage between these two lines, that is VBC. And if you will see here, then same kind of voltage difference across B and C, because I am assuming that whatever wire that has almost zero impedance, under this assumption I can write like this. So due to this reason, I have written here VAB is exactly equal to VAB. Similarly here I can write that is exactly equal to VBC and exactly equal to VCA. So in this way I can able to comment about the voltage, whatever line voltage. So it is possible to comment about the line voltage. So now let us try to see that after calculating the line voltage, it is possible to calculate the phase current. Means if you see from here, that if I know the voltage difference between two line VAB, And since I know the Z delta, so basically IAB, that is nothing but the, either you can interpret that as a line current or phase current, because both are same in magnitude here. So that is nothing but voltage difference VAB by Z delta, or you can write a small VAB by Z delta. So let us write that expression now. So this is about line voltage. Now I am going to talk about the phase current. So basically now I have expression of the phase currents, and if you see the phase current, so basically I am going to write directly now, because we have understood that how basically we are calculating the phase current. So IAB, that is the phase current, that is equal to VAB, and impedance is Z delta. So by Ohm's law I can easily able to write, and we are dealing in frequency domain. So in this whole unit I am only talking about the somehow frequency domain or phasor domain, you can tell. So VBC by Z delta, so these all things are obvious. So I am going to write similarly here VCA by Z delta. So in this way I am able to talk about the phase current and phase voltage. But these current, if you substitute VAB, VBC, VCA, and if you manipulate the complex number, then it is possible to show that, I am going to write that in form of the remark, these current have the same magnitude, because magnitude of VAB, VBC, VCA all are equal. Due to that reason we are writing like this. But if you see phase difference between VAB, VBC, VCA, all are different due to, but are out of phase, because all are not in same phase with each other by 120, and that is obvious because we have generated voltage like this only using generator. Now this is the one way to talk about the phase current, but one can also obtain the phase current by another way, and I am going to discuss the another way also. In this way you are able to picture in more clear fashion. So let us try to write the another way. So I am telling that I am writing in form of note. So another way to get these phase currents is to apply KVL, and in order to apply KVL we have to identify the loop. So let us come to the original circuit again. So in this particular circuit I am going to apply the KVL, and that KVL I am going to apply about this loop A, AB, B, N and A. So basically my loop is this. So I am denoting this as a one loop in order to apply KVL. Then I can also able to generate the phase current. So again, let us come to the application of the KVL. So applying KVL around loop, and whatever loop I have selected, that is AAB upper loop I have selected, and I have already denoted that loop, and that gives, if you see that loop, so I have one voltage, and that voltage is nothing but VAN, means phase voltage, plus Z delta IAB, and after that I have plus VBN, and that equal to zero. So in this way I am able to apply the KVL. Let us check again the after applying KVL why I have written like this. So basically I am traveling in this loop. So if you travel from here to here, then this voltage, so negative to positive, if you take plus, so plus sign is here, but if you will take here, then negative sign, negative IAB Z delta, and here positive to negative. So again I have if I am traveling from positive to negative, so I have negative sign, that is VBN, and if you take negative sign everywhere, then this is VAN minus VBN comes into picture, that become positive, and finally I am getting VAB here. So in this way I have written this KVL equation. So now let us come to the KVL equation, because that is now obvious, because several time we are dealing with KVL and KCL. So now I hope that you all are become very much comfortable with KVL and KCL. So IAB is VAN minus VBN by Z delta, and that is VAB by Z delta, because in phasor we have already observed that VAN minus VBN by VAB, and what we have found here, that whatever VAB, that is exactly same as the VAB by Z delta. So in this way also I can able to find the phase current, and means this is more transparent, and means there is no confusion involved if you apply this kind of technique. And if you want to calculate the line current, so in order to calculate the line current, now I can apply the KCL. So let us try to find the line current in another way. So the line currents are obtained from the phase currents by applying KCL at nodes A, B and C. So let us come to the figure again. So whenever we have to apply KVL and KCL, then we have to see figure again and again. So here I have this particular point, I have this particular point, and I have this particular point. So I am going to apply basically KVL across these particular points, like this, this, and this. So here you can see that this current IA is coming here, and after that I have two current, that is IAB. So this is outgoing current, and after that I have one more incoming current, ICA. So basically, if you see the expression about this particular point, KCL, if you apply, so apply KCL, then it is possible to show that IA, and that is exactly equal to the IAB, that is the outgoing current, and minus ICA, because this is also a incoming current. Sum of all incoming current is equal to outgoing current. And similarly, I can write here IB, that is equal to IBC minus IAB, and IC is ICA minus IBC. So in this way, I am able to write. And after that, I will use the value of ICA in order to calculate the all other value of current. So let us first write, and after that we will proceed towards the next step. So after applying the KCL, it is possible to again write like this. Thus IA is nothing but IAB minus ICA, and similarly the IB, that is the line current, and line current is IBC minus IAB, and after that similarly IC is ICA minus IBC. Now what we have found, that basically ICA is IAB, and this is out of phase by 240 degree. So if I substitute this kind of expression here, then it is possible to again, and this whatever relation I have written, we have already seen that the current has same magnitude, but they are of out of phase. And if you substitute this value, then IA is IAB minus ICA, and that is nothing but IAB into 1 minus 1 minus 240 degree. And so another way you can also interpret, that after applying KVL in all loop, I am able to find IAB, IBC, ICA, and after that I am going to substitute that value here, and after that what happens, I have IAB 1 plus 0.5 minus j 0.866. so if you solve this complex number, so here whenever we are dealing with the frequency domain, then complex number comes into picture, so we have to deal with the complex number. Due to that reason, means you may have found that during 10 plus 2, people are giving lot of emphasis on the complex number. So complex number, in reality, that will not exist. But for the application or for the analysis, use of complex number is very, very vital. And if you involve complex number, then things become more simple. That is the beauty of the complex number. And here you can see that IA is IB root 3 and angle is minus 30 degree. So basically the line current is root 3 times the magnitude IP of the phase current. So now I am going to write like this. Basically IL is root 3 IP. So I am just talking where IL is the line current, and this is basically the magnitude of the line current, and IP is the magnitude of the phase current. So in this way we have found the relationship between line current and the phase current. So from this expression it is possible to establish this kind of relationship, and it is also possible to show the following, that IL is the magnitude of IA, that is magnitude of the IB and the magnitude of the IC. Similarly, IP, I am interpreting phase current, that is IAB equal to IBC equal to ICA. So in this way, we have defined the line current and phase current, and after that, we are seeing the relationship. And in the next diagram, and this diagram is also called the phasor diagram. So this is nothing but the phasor diagram. So same kind of things we have done algebraically, I am going to denote here. So I have here, you can see that I have current like IA, IC and IB. Basically here one term is missing, that is IAB, and it is possible to observe here the line current, that is IA or IB or IC, lacks the corresponding phase current. So phase current is IAB, IBC, ICA by 30 degree, and if you assume the positive sequence, and using phasor diagram one can basically draw this kind of relationship. So let us just write this kind of things in form of the remark. So remark is the line currents lag the corresponding phase current by 30 degree, assuming the positive sequence. And here please be careful that whatever way I have defined the line current or phase current, then I have this kind of relationship like this. So I am assuming that line current IL. So if I have Y generated load and whatever current that is flowing between a small a to capital A, that is the line current, and whatever current that is flowing between capital A to capital B, that is I am interpreting as a phase current. So using this definition, I am writing like this. If you define in different way, then you have to change these kind of remark according to your definition, because most of time either you can believe on a standard definition or you can interchangeably you can use phase current or line current, and you can define that I am interpreting line current and phase current like this. But it is better to follow the standard way. So this is the standard way. So this is the another way to talk about the line current and phase current. One more alternative, because when I have started Y to Y connection, at that time what I have told you, that basically Y to Y connected is very very primitive structure. So another alternate way to convert Y delta circuit into YY circuit or YY system by some kind of equivalence between delta and Y. So another alternative, way of analyzing the Y delta circuit is to transform the delta connected load to an equivalent Y connected load. And I have already told you that means if I have Y connected and delta connected, then whatever during the analysis of DC, but we have found that whenever we have same kind of resistance R1, R2 and R3, then if you convert from delta to Y, at that time this kind of relation come into picture. So I am going to write the transformation formula. So please check that kind of things from the DC part. I am not again going to repeat that, or any standard book that is available. So using the delta Y transformation फॉर्मेशन फॉर्मूला इट इज पॉसिबल टू राइट जेड वाई इज जेड डेल्टा बाई थ्री. सो दिस इज द रिलेशन इफ ऑल resistance or impedance are equal, because in case of the resistive network we are just talking about the resistance. And I have told you that in frequency domain, even if we have means capacitor or inductor, we are not making difference because we are interpreting as a impedance. So somehow impedance is exactly equivalent to the resistance, but impedance contains some kind of complex part also, but relation remains exactly the same. So from that relation I have converted now delta connected load into Y connected. And in the previous class we have already analyzed the YY system, and what we have found that if I have YY system, then I can make an equivalent circuit, and using that equivalent circuit it is possible to talk about the phase current. So basically now after transformation, so after the transformation we now have YY system. And previous class we have already analyze the YY system, so I am going to use the same result. And what we have found during analysis, that in YY system this is the single phase voltage, and this suppose IA is the line current, and after that I have to here put the impedance, and here I have to put impedance in form of Y. So this type of equivalent circuit we are able to get in case of YY system. So basically here in place of load Z delta, just I have to write Z delta by 3. So basically this figure represent a single phase equivalent circuit of balanced Y delta circuit. And in this way also one can see that phase current leads the corresponding line current by 30 degrees. So till now what we have seen, that if I have Y delta connected system, then I can analyze this system at least in three different way. So in first way, using the help of positive sequence, I will calculate the line voltage, and if I know the line voltage, then I am able to talk about the phase current as well as the line current. Another way, I have used KVL and KCL. Then again I have established relation between the phase current and line current, because but we have found that the line voltage and phase voltage are basically have same magnitude, but there exists some kind of phase difference between that. And third way, what we have found that it is possible to convert the Y delta system to YY system, and once I have YY system, then I can interpret YY system as a single phase equivalent circuit, and using that equivalent circuit, again I am able to establish all kind of relation same like the previous chapter. Now let us come to one numerical example, and after that I am going to close the today's lecture. So here I have taken a balanced ABC sequence Y connected source, and here VAN is 100, I am assuming that 110 volt, and that is connected to balance load, and magnitude of balance load is 8 plus j 4 omega per phase. Now I have to calculate these two quantity, phase current, so I know VAB and I know this. So here I am going to give you the two different way to solve this problem. So one way, here what we have observed that load impedance, that is I have represent load impedance in form of phasor. So just I have converted this complex number in polar form, and after that I have seen the phase voltage like this, and we know that source is basically balanced and that is connected in ABC sequence. So if I know the one voltage, it is possible to talk about the another one, or in another way, if I know VAN, it is possible to calculate the VAB, because what we have observed during the theoretical part that VAB is VAN root 3, and that is also equal to the line voltage. And after that I am able to calculate the phase current by dividing the line voltage by the impedance, so magnitude of that is like this. Similarly, I can get IBC, because once I know VAB, and second IBC due to positive sequence, that is IAB is leads to IBC by 120 degree, and similarly IC is leads by IA by 120 degree. So it is possible to calculate IAB, IBC and ICA, and after that I am able to talk about the line current, and line current I am able to generate like this, that is IA, IB and IC. And we have already seen that is the phase current relation between line current and phase current, that is 30 degree apart. Due to that reason I am able to calculate like this. And another way is I can able to convert the Y delta system, YY system, and after that I will calculate the line current. So what I have seen that if you converted delta system into Y system, then we are exactly getting like this, and after that we are able to get this. And other line current one can calculate by keeping in mind that this is ABC sequence. So in this way we are able to solve the problem related to balanced Y delta connection. And this is the basically most practical three phase system, because most of time we are connecting like this only. So with this remark, I am going to close the today's lecture. Thank you very much.